Hello, good morning dear students. See, yesterday we have started the new schedule, that is schedule number 7. In that we are discussing about the density, mass and formulas. Okay, so yesterday we have discussed about what is a density, a unit of density, and what is a formula of a density. So today we practically we will see how to see the density and calculate density and some formulas also. Now see here, the density means what? As you know that the mass per unit volume of a body, okay, means anything, whatever thing you will take, then how to calculate the density of that particular substance, the mass per unit volume, what is the mass of that substance and volume, then you will get the density of that particular thing. Okay, then this is the symbol of density, it's known as a rho. Okay, RHO, rho, this symbol is known as a rho. This density is denoted by this symbol, is equal to M means mass and V means what? Volume. So this is the formula of density. Okay, this is very important. This symbol is also important. This symbol is known as rho, RHO. Okay, and this density is denoted by this symbol, and the formula of density is mass per unit of volume. Now see, the SI unit of density is kg per meter cube, and CGS unit of density is gram per centimeter cube. This already we have discussed yesterday. Okay, now we will see some practical, but before to start the practical, some of the basic information. Now see here, as we discussed yesterday, that is this density formula is mass per unit volume. Okay, and it's totally depend on the how the molecular arrangement in the particular substance. So you know that if a solid substance, and the, in solid substance molecular arrangement means what? It is a closely packed to each other, very tightly packed to each other, means what? Mass already, it is more mass. Okay, so if mass is increases, then density is also increases. Okay, we have discussed yesterday. Now see here, in front of you, in this beaker oil is there, okay, and in this beaker water. Now whose density, now you have to compare with water, whose density is more. If any substance density is more, now see, this is the stone. See here, this one is a stone and this is water. Okay, now we have to think about whose density is more. If this oil density is more, then it will be sink in the water. If this is more, then it will be sink in the water. Now just we have to observe it. See here, in this beaker we'll take a water, okay, and now I'm adding this I put this stone. See, now stone is settled downside, it is a sink in the water, means what? The stone density is more than water. As you know that stone is a solid, so the molecules are very tightly packed, okay, tightly packed to each other, means its mass is more than the water. So mass, this stone is sink in a water. Okay, now we will see oil. Just see, see here, are you able to see the two layers? See, this first layer is oil and the second layer is a water. So oil is less denser than water, so oil is float on water, but this stone is more denser than water, so stone sink in the water. Understood the density? See, because this mass is more, so it sink in the water, so density is more, stone density is more. Now in this case, water density is more than oil, so oil is floating on water and the water is dancing. Okay, so do you understand about the density? Now some numericals we'll see in a next period. Okay, so now I will stop here. Thank you.